The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 18th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation. Out of many thousands among men, one may endeavor for perfection, and of those who have achieved perfection, hardly one knows me in truth.
Manasanam sahasreshu. Sahasreshu, many times thousands, many times. That means out of millions and trillions of persons. Many times thousand means 100,000 makes 1 lakh. 100 times lakh makes 1 crore. Similarly, 100,000 of crores, billions and trillions, unlimited. First of all, manusha. Manusha means man. So, to get this human form of life, one has to wait for many, many millions of years, according to evolutionary process. Asitin chaturang chaiva, lakhang sang jiva jati. In the Padma Pura, the evolution theory is described. That is taken away by Darwin, and in a perverted way he has described Darwin's theory of evolution. But that is not very scientific, although it is going on as scientific. But evolution theory is fact. Not that all of a sudden you get this body of human being, no. Tatha dehantaram prati. After death, there is another body, dehantara. Just like in this life also, we get dehantara, another body. From baby's body to child's body to boy's body to youth's body. From youth's body to old man's body. Then after old man's body, why not another body? But the rascals, they do not believe transmigration of the soul. It is very quite reasonable. After changing so many bodies, I have come to this old body. So what after this old body? There must be somebody. It is quite reasonable. But these rascals have no brain to understand that there is life after death. Big professors in European countries, they do not believe transmigration of the soul. So manushara, out of the, there are many kinds of men also. Just like kirata hunandra puninda pukkasa abhira sumbha javana khasadaya. The Africans, the Mongolians, the Huns, there are so many, we know, so many types of human beings. Out of that, a few who are known as aliens, they are the best type of human being. And out of the aliens, those who are followers of the Vedic principle, they are the best. But those who are following the Vedic principle, they say that we are Vedic or followers of the Varnasam Dharma. In common sense, they call Hindu. But actually, they say so, they do not follow the principles. They do not follow them. They act against the Vedic principles. Therefore, it is said, that even though one gets this human form of life, after many, many millions of years, the living soul, Still, there are so many divisions in the human form of life. Therefore it is said, manushanam sahasreshu. Out of many millions of human beings, kaschit jatati siddhaye. Siddhaye, siddhaye means to get the spiritual power or spiritual rejuvenation. That is called siddhi. Mukti, mukti, siddhi. There are three kinds of activities going on in the human society. Some people are karmis. They enjoy life, or they want to enjoy life by working hard. Enjoyment means ahara, nidra, bhaya, maithuna. To eat very nicely and to sleep very nicely, to enjoy sex life very nicely, and to make defense, force. This is called enjoyment, material enjoyment. If I am secure by defense force, and if I have got good bank balance, if I have got a very nice, beautiful wife, and if I eat sumptuously to the satisfaction of my tongue, I think I am very much successful. But that is not success. Success is the one thing. This is called bhukti, material enjoyment. So, bhukti, mukti, siddhi. When one is fed up with this hard working for material enjoyment and get little sense above material enjoyment, little sense for spiritual understanding that we have discussed yesterday. Jnanam tiham savijnanam, that is knowledge. To work hard like an ass for sense gratification, that is not siddhi. Siddhi is different thing. Siddhi means to understand the spiritual identification and work for it. That is called siddhi. So, the attempt for such thing is called mukti, to get rid of the material entanglement. So, bhukti, mukti, siddhi. There are three stages. So, siddhi means when one understands his spiritual identity and tries to make his life perfect on that platform, that is called siddhi. Otherwise, bhukti, mukti. In the Chaitanya Chaitamrita, it is said that bhukti, mukti, siddhi kani sakali asanti. So long one is on the platform of bhukti, mukti and siddhi, he is restless. He is working because he is desiring. Siddhi is specially meant for the yogis. The yogis, they want to play wonderful magic. Anima, lagima, prakti, siddhi, visita, bhoshita. There are eight kinds of yoga siddhis. That kind of siddhi is not recommended here. Siddhi means to understand one's spiritual identity and work for it. That is called siddhi. So manushanam sadhu, who knows it? There is no such education. Therefore Krishna says, manushanam sahasri, out of million, million persons, one tries for this siddhi, perfection of life, to understand spiritual identity and to work for it. That is called siddhi. And jatatam api siddhana, one who has attained siddhi and trying for it, further progress, out of them millions of such persons, one can understand what is Krishna. We cannot understand Krishna so easily. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is not understandable by ordinary persons up to the stage of Siddhi. But, as Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, that one can understand me by the process of bhakti, bhaktya mam avijanati, javan jaschami tattat. Here it is said, manushyanam sahasresu kaschid jatati siddhaye, jatatam vi siddhana kaschid man betti tattat. Tattata means to. Simply, superficially, to know Krishna. Just like in the English dictionary, it is said, Krishna, Krishna is mentioned in the dictionary, a Hindu god. So what does he know about Krishna, Hindu god? There are Hindu gods, many. According to our Hindu conception, there are 33 crores of demigods, chief of which is Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu, Surya and Ganapati. Chiefly they worship. In the Hindu world, they worship, somebody worship Vishnu, somebody worship Shiva, somebody worship Brahma, somebody worship the sun. Just like the Parsis, they worship the sun. I think I am right. So, they also can be concluded as Hindus. And actually, they came from Persia when there was Mohammedan disturbance. They fled from their country and came to India. That is the history. These five gods are specially recommended and worshipped. So Krishna is considered in the Vishnu category, therefore in the English dictionary it is said as one of the gods. They are under the conception, foreigners, that Hindus, they have got many gods. But actually that is not fact. There are many gods means that like godly, because they are servants of Krishna. Just like in royal palace, even the servants are dressed with royal garments. Similarly, the chief servants of Krishna, like Indra, Chandra, Surya is also servant. Chandra, that is also servant. Indra is also servant. As it is stated in the Brahma Sangita, Jasyadvaya bhramati saṁ bhritakāla chakro. The sun, so powerful God, the sun, we see the sun planet, but within the sun planet, there is the sun God, whose name is mentioned also in the Bhagavad Gita, Vibhashyam. Just like you know your president's name, Mr. Nixon. Similarly, we know who is the predominating deity in the sun planet. How we know? We know from Bhagavad Gita. Vibhashan manabe praho. Vibhashan, the president or the predominating deity in the sun planet is called Vibhashan. His son is Manu, and from Manu, the Manusha. Mano, manusha means first coming from Mano. The human race has come from the Mano. Therefore, the Vedic followers, they follow the principles of course of Mano Sanghita. Mano Sangha is the law, Hindu law, is still accepted, although they have made many amendments. But it is not to be amended. Just like the Manu Sangita, there is no divorce. Now, our Hindu laws, they have amended. Divorce is allowed. That is not according to Manu Sangita. So, there are different kinds of men. Now, out of many such millions and trillions different kinds of men in the human form of life, some may attain to achieve success of life. What is that success of life? Success of life to understand his spiritual identity. At the present moment, being conditioned by the material nature, every man is working under the impression that I am this body. I am Indian because I got this body from India. I am American, I got this body from America. All bodily concept of life. Or I am Hindu because I am born of a Hindu family. I am Christian because I am born of a Christian family. These are all bodily identification. When one goes above the bodily identification, that is called Siddhi. This is the explanation of Siddhi. In the bodily platform, nobody can attain perfection. He is anyone. Those who are in the bodily concept of life, those who are thinking that I am Indian, I am American, I am African, I am Hindu, I am Muslim, I am Christian, I am Buddhist, they are all animals. They are not human beings. Because bodily concept. In the Shastra says, Jasya ko buddhi kunapi tidhatuke sadhik kalatra disubhoma ijjadhi jati sa buddhi salile na tarhiche saeva go khara. Go khara, go means cow and khara means ass. So those who are in the bodily concept of life, they are no better than the cows and the asses. This is the Shastra's verdict. So modern civilization, everyone, mostly, they are under the bodily concept of life and they are fighting like animals because that is animal life. Therefore Krishna instructs at the end that you Hindus, Muslims, Christians, this, that, kindly kick out all these concepts and of religion. Sarva dharman parityajya. Because this is not religion. This is bodily concept of life. The business of ass and cows. So you give up this business. Sarva dharman parityajya. Krishna says in the beginning, dharma samasthapanathaya sambhavami jigayuge. I come down just to re-establish the principles of religion. What is that religion? Not this Hindu religion, Muslim religion, Christian religion. Those who are thinking that we are preaching Hindu religion. No. We are not preaching Hindu religion. Therefore, I am registering the association. I purposely kept this name, Krishna consciousness. Neither Hindu religion, nor Christian religion, nor Buddhist religion. Krishna does not belong to any sect. Those who are thinking that you are sectarian, they are wrong. Because Krishna does not belong to any sect. He says in the Bhagavad Gita, Sarva-joneshu sambhavanti murtayaja. Jonesu, not only human society. Joni means forms of life or species of life. Sarva-joneshu. So, the forms of life are 8,400,000 forms of life. Jalayanavrakhani thavara lakhavimsati. 900,000 species of life in the water. Who knows that? But Krishna knows. Krishna, because he is the father, Krishna said, sarva-joneshu kaunteya sambhavanti murtayaja tathan mahajani brahma aham bija padavita. Krishna has given birth to the aquatics, to the trees, to the plants, to the birds, to the beasts, to the human being, to the demigods, everyone, sarva-joneshu, including everyone. So how Krishna consciousness can be sectarian? Just like our men went to consult about taxation, they are considering that this is sectarian, Krishna. This is not sectarian. Where is sectarian? Krishna says, sarva-joneshu. not only international, universal. Chaitanya is achieving for everyone. Otherwise, how everyone outside India, they are accepting this Krishna consciousness, if it is sectarian. It is not sectarian. Krishna consciousness, Krishna himself says that I am the father of all forms of life. How Krishna can be sectarian? There is no reason to say that it is sectarian. Therefore it is said that somebody thinking that Krishna is Hindu god, somebody is thinking Krishna was born in India, therefore he is Indian. Krishna took birth in the family of Jyotu dynasty, therefore he is Kshatriya. Krishna played as a cowherd boy in Vrindavan, therefore he is Vaishya. In so many ways they are thinking, but Krishna says this is all rascalism. Therefore he says, Koshit Vetimam Tototo. Actually what I am, that is known to very, very few men, only to the devotees, not to the common man. This is the idea. Krishna is not Sachaya. Krishna is not Hindu. Krishna is not Indian. Krishna is not African. Krishna is nothing of this material world. He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, transcendental. Simply by knowing Krishna, one becomes immediately liberated and goes back to Krishna. Simply by knowing Krishna. Janma karma me vidvam ji janati tattva. This very thing again, tattva. His activities, his coming down, his work, they are all transcendental, big bomb, not ordinary. So, he is big bomb, he is transcendental. If anyone knows in truth, then what happens to him? Sattādiham punarjanmunaiti. Simply by knowing as he is, one becomes immediately liberated. Immediately. So, therefore, it is said, manusana, because if one would know Krishna as he is, he will immediately be liberated. So liberation is not so cheap thing. Therefore Krishna says, manushanam sahasyesu paschi vittimam tattata jatatam api siddhyanam paschi vittimam tattata. So you can understand Krishna. Therefore Krishna said in the beginning of this chapter, that jnanam means jnanam tiham savijnam. It is a great science. It is not a speculative, it is not imagination. Just like sometimes they create, imagine God. The impersonalists, they think there is no God, God is not personal, but is impersonal. So you can imagine any form. That is ascalism. That is not Krishna, that is not God. How, with your limited senses, imperfect senses, you can imagine God? Whatever you imagine, that is ascalism. That is not Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, manushanam sahasyesu paschid vettimam tattva. If you want to know Krishna, then you must become Krishna's devotee. Bhaktyamam avijanati. You cannot understand by your so-called scholarship. Imaginative power. That is not possible. Adhāpi te deva padāmu jadva prasāda lesāna grihita evai jānāti tattam. Again, that tattam. One who has achieved a little favor of you, he can understand you by tattva, in truth. Adhāpi te deva padāmu jadva prasāda padāmu jadva प्रसाद लेशान गृहीतये जानाति तत्तम न चान्न न च अन्न चिरं फॉर गुड फॉर मेनी मेनी मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स विचिन्नम सिंपल बाय स्पेकुलेशन दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल देयर आर मेनी प्लेसेस लाइक दैट पंथा सुकोटि शतवत्स संप्रगम वायु रथापि मनसो मुनिपुंगमाना सप्पस्तिसा विचिन्त तत्ते if you simply speculate to understand God. He is immense, inconceivable, even if you endeavor for millions and billions of years. That is not possible. In another place Krishna says, Bahunam Janmanavante. Not only billions and billions, but after many billions and millions of birth, Bhavanam Janvanam Ante, Jnanavan, when one is actually on the platform of knowledge, Mahanaparpadjante, he surrenders to Krishna. Why? Because he understands at that time, Vasudeva Sarvamiti, Sa Mahatma Subhidhu. That is Mahatma. Vasudeva, Krishna is everything. That will explain how Krishna is everything in this chapter. Jnanam tiham sabhijnanam. How Krishna is everything, that will explain in this chapter. So, if we want to understand Krishna, it is not to be done by our scholarship. It may be this, it may be that. That is all asceta. You should understand as Krishna says. Then you will understand Krishna. How you can understand? You are so imperfect. You cannot understand even yourself. You do not know what you are. You are thinking that you are body. I am thinking I am this body. The body we consider is the business of the cows and the asses. How the cows and asses can understand Krishna? They cannot understand. If you want to understand Krishna, then you should hear from Krishna and take it as it is. Then you will understand. If you are fortunate enough, then you will understand. Manushyanam sahasresu kasti jagati siddhaye yatatama visiddhyanam kasti vetimam tattata. Tattata means truth. You can understand that Krishna was an Indian. He has gone in like that. Just like Arjuna also said, aparang bhavato janma param janma bhuvasata katham etat vijanyam. So, he also, Arjuna understood Krishna because Krishna, Arjuna was the devotee of Krishna. But to clear the idea of Krishna as the rascal's death, he asked this question, aparang bhavato janma, that your birth is, just recently, say 100 years ago, but the sun planet, millions of years, how can I believe that you spoke this philosophy or science to the sun god who was sun? So the reply was that, my dear Arjuna, you are my devotee. Whenever I appear, you also appear, but I remember what I spoke to the sun god. You are also present at that time with me, but you have forgotten. I have not forgotten. That is the difference between Krishna and Arjuna, or God and human. That is the difference. Vidaham samititam. Krishna, God knows everything, past, present and future. Just like in the Bhagavata in the beginning, God means janmardasya jataha, from whom everything has emanated. So everyone can say, I have given birth to so many children, so many houses, so many factories, I am also God. No, you cannot be God. Because you do not know abhijna, you do not know the past, present and future. Janmardasya jataha, annaya itaratascha arthesu abhijna. Krishna is abhijna. Just like in our body, we are eating. How this eating and the substance is transformed into different secretion and again blood, again flesh, again bone. How this are, we do not know. But it is actually happening. Annayat itadateshu. I know that I am eating, but itadateshu. How this eating substance has transformed into bones, marrow, stools, that I do not know. Therefore I am not avijna. But about Krishna, it is said, avijna, he knows everything. How this world is going on, how these planets are rotating, how seasons are changing, jasyantvayam hramatisaṁ vṛtakāla chakra. Actually, it is happening due to the rotation of the sun, every scientist knows. But how the rotation of sun is going on, that they do not know. That we know. How? 96 in the Brahma Samhita, jasyantvayam hramatisaṁ vṛtakāla chakra. The sun is moving by his order. Mayadhyakshena prakriti suyate sacharacharam. Under my supervision, everything is going on. That is Krishna. Krishna is not ordinary thing. So one who tries to understand Krishna in true tattva is very, very fortunate. Therefore he is called manushyanam sahasreshu. The fortune does not come to everyone and anyone. Out of millions of persons. Therefore, who have taken Krishna, who have understood Krishna in tattva, as far as his knowledge is concerned, is very, very fortunate. Eirupe brahmanna bhomite kuno bhagavan ji, Lord Chaitanya Mahavishnu. That we are wandering throughout the universe in many species of life. And when you come to this human form of life, if you are fortunate, or if you are fortunate to meet another fortunate devotee, then you can understand what is Krishna. Thank you very much.